such displeasure and disappointment. Nothing works, even though every calculation is precise. Now an interruption. How infuriating. Wait, wait. Sometimes the great gear turns from frustration to opportunity. Divine energy. I'll have you know I participated in Lord Sothesil's 9 analyses of the Exalted Enigmas. But we have more important matters. I'm about to determine the correlation between color and time, and I could use another set of hands. A reciprocal exchange. Interesting, yes. I can see the benefits of such an arrangement. Very well. Just activate the crystals in the proper sequence while I modulate the energy flow. Less chance of an explosion that way. You activate the crystals. Look for pure light, not muddled. I'll modulate the energy fluctuations, make sure nothing explodes. If color confounds you, good help is as rare as the legendary Last Dwemer. But a clockwork is only as strong as its weakest cog. Just work your way up the rainbow. If the color isn't clear, examine the crystals. Start with the simplest shape and end with the most complex. Such are the benefits of an extra set of appendages. The energy flows freely and without disruption, allowing the rods and the pistons to align in a most pleasing manner. Thank you. Now, why do you want to know about divine energy? Scent. How intriguing. I was just thinking about my former master, Sothesil, and the experiments we conducted. He desperately sought to understand the power he and his companions attained. Especially whether or not that power was temporary. Not while I assisted him. He had a tool that he used to drain away minute bits of his own divine energy to store and study. He could extract it and return it as he saw fit. Not sure what became of the tool, but here are my notes from those days. More questions?
Well, Lord Sofa Seal attributed curiosity to intellectual superiority. Suppose I should do the same. Ask, and I will attempt to tighten the cogs of your ongoing education as best I can. Odd question. Is a hammer a weapon? A saw? A Dwemer spring spanner? No, it was just a tool. A device crafted by Sofa Seal to aid in his endless experiments. Suppose I could imagine ways to modify the device, but for what reason? Haven't a clue. I was his apprentice, but that was years ago. Spent time working in the Clockwork City. That's what I learned about energy transference, Dwemer engineering, mechanical symmetry. Made me the Dark Elf I am today. I have a question. Who sent you? The Arch-Colonel. Lord Vivek's High Priest. Suddenly the gears align. I can think of a number of reasons that Almond V would want to know about C and his tools. Some doors just shouldn't be opened. He's the father of mysteries, the architect of time, one of the tribunal, the three living gods of the Dark Elves. Creates all sorts of helpful and intriguing devices, like the Clockwork City. I haven't seen my old master in many years. It's a wonder and a miracle. All brass tunnels, glass domes, and giant gears. He was inspired by the work of the Dwemer. Clockwork City is pure Sofa Seal. He made it to forge the future and reshape the world. I learned a lot there.